Hello and welcome to the Genshin Impact version 2.1 special program. I'm your host, Zach Aguilar, the voice of Ether. And today I'm joined by my long-lost sibling and co-host.
Hi everyone, I'm Sarah Miller-Cruz and you all know me as the voice of Lumine in Genshin Impact. Good to see you, Twinsy.
Hey, right back at ya. All right, everyone. Today, we have a particularly special program as Genshin Impact will soon be rolling into its one-year anniversary celebration.
Yay! Oh my gosh, I can't believe it's already been one whole year already. Oh,
I know, right? Time has been flying crazy fast.
I know.
We've already had so many amazing adventures with everyone.
Definitely, and thank you so much to all our travelers out there for your support. It's been such an amazing year together. And it's safe to say that with the coming version, Genshin Impact will not only be providing more great in-game content, but also some exciting events outside the game.
That's right. I'm really excited to celebrate already.
I know. So I hope everyone can feel the anniversary hype and the appreciation that the Genshin Impact team has for all our travelers.
And speaking of one year of adventures, joining us today are some talented voices that players have been hearing from the very onset of their adventures. Please welcome...
Dun, da, da, da.
Hey everyone, I'm Stephanie Sutherland, voice of Jean, the acting grandmaster of the Knights of Favonius.
What's up everybody, I'm Josie Montana McCoy, the voice of Kaya, cavalry captain of the Knights of Favonius.
Elrider Amber reporting in. Hey everybody, I'm Kelly Baskin, the voice of Amber. And finally, we have...
Hi everyone, I'm Laura Stahl, the voice behind Mondstadt's Deaconess Idol, Barbara. Let's do our best today.
All right, I believe that's everyone.
Yay! Oof.
We've got a full house today, hey guys.
Yay, we do.
So we'll all be teaming up to host this special program together.
This is great. So many people.
I know. This is so amazing. We've got a big group today. Hopefully things don't get too crazy.
I'll be watching all of you.
Thanks so much, Eugene.
Got it. You got it.
Anyway, we'll be counting on you to show us the ropes, Zach. You'll be our special program senpai for the day.
Yeah, seriously, like, how many of these have you done already, Zach? A lot, right?
Yeah, you know, like a few, but don't worry, I got this.
Oh, we all know you do, Zach. Hey, every program so far has been just a little bit different, so I'm pretty sure that there's going to be some special twist this time around too, isn't there?
Yeah, for sure. In fact, the special program writers have come up with a couple little mini games for all the voice artists to interact together, so be sure to stay tuned for that.
Yeah. You're kidding!
Yeah!
I'm definitely looking forward to that. Mm-hmm. All right then, with no further ado, let's have a first look at the official trailer for Genshin Impact version 2.1, Floating World Under the Moonlight.
Yay!
Yay!
Repeat after me. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3.
You know, the earliest shrine on Watatsumi Island was not located in Sangonomiya. But after she struck down our protector deity, the shrine was abandoned.
Recently, some of our soldiers started showing symptoms of accelerated aging.
If that's the case, then the peace talks are likely a trap.
The way people charge in here as they please. So uncivilized.
Senyora is the one behind all this? Ugh, not her again!
Have you learned your lesson now? The way you follow me around like a dark shadow.
Not even ashes will remain!
Let's get them! Protect Madame Kujo!
I will do everything within my power to defend my family's honor.
Strike! Storm the front!
You Kujo scum! Colluding with the Fatui isn't low enough for you already! You just want to take everything away from us!
To survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship.
Rest and rebuild! Covenant of the
Some ambitions have the power to heal wounds, to bring victory. Indulge my curiosity. What is the reason that I find you standing here before me once again?
Shine down! Now you shall perish!
Surely you don't think your ambition alone is enough to shake A's will, do you?
That's it. Just like that. Eternity stretches things out over a long time.
But each moment within it becomes all the more fragile.
You know, this is starting to feel like chili pepper weather.
Did you happen to see how the city looked on the way over here? Everyone's getting ready for the Moon Chase Festival. I'm taking part in this year's Masterful Chefs. If possible, I'd like you to be my culinary consultant.
There is one dish that perhaps you could try making for me.
We have two extraordinary talents this year. I'm interested to see their choice of dishes.
Okay, without further ado, let the cooking commence. Begin!
Welcome back, everyone!
Yay! Wow.
So, as we just saw in the trailer, version 2.1 will be bringing everyone on an adventure celebrating another one of Liyue's traditional festivals, the Moon Chase Festival.
Tibet has so many festivals.
I'm not complaining.
I know, right?
The Moon Chase Festival is an event with lots of meaning to the people of Liyue. It's a time when all the locals gather together and do what they do best. Enjoy a variety of local foods.
Ooh, I love food.
Whenever anyone mentions food and Liyue, you know what comes to mind?
Try something new at the Wanmin restaurant.
Well, yeah, I guess that comes to mind too. Well, what I was going to say is you can't help but think of Liyue's resident chef, Xiangling.
Oh, right, Xiangling.
Yeah.
Okay. Uh-huh. Well, I still like that impression, though, Zach. That was pretty
good. Yeah, good job. Well done.
Yeah.
Thanks, sure. Steph.
Same.
So, in addition to lots of tasty food, the Moon Chase Festival also has a rich background of traditional culture and customs.
It's said that in ancient times, The Moon Chase Festival was once associated with adepti that were pursuing the adeptal path.
That's right, but such folk legends are hard to verify now. The present meaning of the Moon Chase Festival primarily lies now in celebrating the arrival of fall by moonlight. In addition to enjoying activities in the radiant moonlight, people will visit friends and relatives, and as well as enjoy a variety of entertainment and events.
Okay. So, in other words, it's another chance for everyone to gather around the table and enjoy a big meal together, right?
Yeah. I mean, I like food, and like any festival, the whole city joins in on the celebration. Travelers will notice some changes in Liyue Harbor throughout the course of the festival, with the entire city decked out in festive decor.
Oh, it's so pretty! I want to go to there!
During the Moon Chase Festival, merchants will also set up their stalls and cover the alleys in advertisements to attract customers.
Ooh, nice! I'm sure we'll find some interesting things for sale.
If the Moon Chase Festival is the main event for version 2.1, what can players expect story-wise? Are we going to get a new event storyline? Say yes, please.
You bet we are.
Yeah!
Yes! This time around, travelers will find themselves partnering up with Kuching and Xiangling to travel around Liyue in search of the true origins of the Moon Chase Festival.
Ooh.
They'll even be doing some cooking and trying out new recipes along the way.
Oh!
Yay! That's so good! And what good would food be without friends? Mm. Travelers will be meeting up with a whole host of good friends from Liyue, so I'm sure we'll be seeing plenty of familiar faces throughout the story.
Great. It's always fun to see characters making an appearance for the events.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
Okay. Yay!
Okay, so besides the Moon Chase event storyline, what else can travelers expect to see coming with the Moon Chase Festival?
That's a good question, and I got you covered.
Oh, yeah, you do.
In addition to the event storyline, there will be two types of event gameplay. The first is called Moonlight Seeker. During the event period, the Adventurers Guild will be scattering things called Moonchase Charms and Mist Moon Chests all around the areas of Liyue, Mondstadt, and Dragonspine.
Oh, okay, cool. Right.
Yes.
Cool.
Travelers can speak with the event organizer to gain some clues, which will help you locate the items faster.
Okay, wait a second. That sounds like a big treasure hunt. I love treasure hunts! I love treasure hunts! It's so cool!
That's right! So, Mist Moon Chests will drop rewards as soon as they are opened, and travelers can collect certain amounts of Moonchase Charms to receive even more rewards.
Ooh, new treasure chest to open. That's always fun.
Mm-hmm. I know! And as Zhongli himself said, us travelers have a treasure-finding talent surpassed.
Okay, nice try, Sarah, but I think Zhongli sounds a little more like this.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember, but where are those who share that memory?
Oh my
god. Zach!
That's good, but seriously, you two, getting back to the event. We should also mention that the rewards for Moonlight Seeker include a brand new 4-star claymore, Luxurious Sea Lord.
Wait, is this real?
Luxurious Sea Lord. Oh my goodness.
It's a whole fish. Josie! Josie, that is not a sword, honey. That is a fish.
Yeah. That's right. It's a big fish. The hilly trolls won't know what hit him.
Yes, they will. He's a fish.
Okay.
Come on.
We're getting weird weapons.
Yes. Okay. I'm sorry. That's insane. Oh my gosh. Genshin Impact wins the internet. Anyway. I'm sorry. Woo. I am a professional. Anyway. Okay. Will travelers be able to exchange rewards to fully refine this weapon? Like in previous events, is that going to be a thing?
That's right.
Oh my
gosh. The weapons refinement materials will all be available as event rewards.
I'm so happy.
I mean, I guess even a fish sword needs refinement materials.
Yeah, it's called seasoning, Zach.
We still have another type of event gameplay to cover too. And the second part of event gameplay is called Trail of Delicacies.
Ooh, fancy.
That sounds like my kind of event.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Travelers will be tasked with locating camps of monsters across different areas and challenging a variety of enemies. Each camp will have leaders that have been affected by some special buffs or effects. Additionally, players will be able to submit dishes as offerings to receive corresponding buff effects, which in turn will then help travelers complete challenges.
Okay. That sounds yummy. Food and monsters, there is nothing wrong with that.
Not at all.
You are correct. Yep, I guess it's time to put those cooking skills to good use, travelers.
And that's not all, because to celebrate the one-year anniversary of Genshin Impact, travelers will be able to participate in the new Passage of Clouds and Stars login event.
Oh.
Simply accumulate daily logins throughout the event period to claim up to 10 intertwined fate along with various other rewards.
That's awesome. And there's one more important note. Every traveler across all servers will have their double crystal bonus reset, which means everyone will be able to enjoy a double amount of crystals for a purchase again.
Oh, that's so nice.
There is so much to enjoy here. While Moonchase is underway back in Liyue, things will also continue unfolding in the tumultuous nation of Inazuma. In version 2.1, travelers will pick up right where the 2.0 story left off and continue on their adventure through the main storyline.
The
story from 2.0 was so jam-packed. I mean, so many important things were happening. Like, I don't know about you guys, but I bet everyone's already dying to know what happens.
I want to know, please. Seriously. But just as a disclaimer, for anyone that hasn't cleared the storyline from 2.0 yet, spoiler alert.
Oh no, avert your eyes!
All right. Take it away, Stephanie.
All right. So, in the last chapter, the Traveler joined the ranks of the resistance forces fighting against the Shogunate. However, we still don't know what challenges lay ahead for the resistance and the Traveler.
Uh-oh.
Does the Traveler actually stand a chance of shaking the Raiden Shogun's persistent and unwavering pursuit of eternity?
This storyline is really building up. I am like super excited.
So for all our travelers who are anxiously waiting to see what will happen next, the story will continue unfolding in the final chapter of the Inazuma Archon quest, arriving in version 2.1. Omnipresence over mortals.
Whoa. And from the title, it seems like the story will still be revolving heavily around the Raiden Shogun.
Yeah, definitely. What lengths will the Traveler go to in order to turn the situation in Inazuma and alter the imposing will of the Almighty Shogun? All the answers will be revealed in the coming Archon Quest.
Dun, dun, dun!
Wait. Zach. Well, is that it? You can't tell us anything else? What else is gonna happen next?
Well, we've gotta be careful when it comes to story content, you know? Like, we don't wanna ruin it for anybody.
But I don't know.
Okay, well, just as a sneak peek, we do have some screenshots from the 2.1 storyline to share with everyone. So, let's have a look!
Give me!
The Raiden Shogun created Musojin Gorge in one slash? Wow, that's pretty incredible.
Yes, but the Archon War was brutal. And Yashiori Island was completely destroyed during that battle. They say the Shogun lost something very dear to her along the way, too.
If I'm remembering correctly, we already knew that Musujin Gorge was the result of Raiden Shogun's blade, right? But what did she mean when she said the Shogun lost something very dear to her along the way?
Right. Well, hopefully travelers have paid attention throughout their travels and picked up on what has taken place in Inazuma up till now.
Clues and hints.
I'm pretty sure everyone has their own guesses about what she may have lost, but all I can say is that the gradual process of losing things and facing changes over the years have had a big influence on the Shogun.
Maybe this was the catalyst behind the Shogun's decision for the Fission Hunt Decree and the Sakoku Decree. What do you think? Do you think the things I think?
Yeah.
Right?
I think you might be right.
But you know, I can't help but wonder if the Raiden Shogun is really the cold-hearted character we saw in version 2.0. There seems to be a lot of questions surrounding her.
Right, there's definitely a fair amount of mystery surrounding her.
For sure.
Mysterious indeed, but the good news is that we'll all have the chance to learn a lot more in the coming version update. On to our next screenshot!
Onward! Let's go! Let's go!
Barely two words in, and you already look like you want me dead. You're getting all worked up over nothing. You've changed. You're getting weak.
Whoa!
Scaramouche, aka the Balladeer, finally makes another appearance. It seems you can never predict when that guy is gonna show up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No.
I believe the last time we saw him was in the Unreconciled Stars event back in version 1.1.
Oh my gosh, you're right.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
You know, I also noticed that the Senora was in the trailer earlier as well.
Right, uh-oh. Right.
Seems there's always some trouble wherever those two show up. It can't be a coincidence that both of these Fatui Harbingers are making an appearance in Inazuma at the same time.
That's a really good point.
Yes, the Balladeer seems like they'll be playing an even bigger role this time.
Well, he is number six of the Fatui Harbingers. Any encounter with him is going to be pretty epic, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
The Traveler was looking pretty serious when they were confronting Scaramouche, and all he said was that they were getting worked up over nothing. I wonder what the situation could be.
I bet they stole his fish.
Oh, for sure.
I mean,
not the fish.
Maybe.
Gotta be.
I think players will have to play the story and find the answer for themselves.
I knew it.
No spoilers.
Gotta be.
No spoilers.
Well, before we move on, there's one more thing I'd like to mention about the Balladeer here. When travelers successfully complete the new storyline, they'll discover the true origins of Scaramouche.
I beg your pardon, really?
Yeah.
Wow. I need it right now.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I've always been wondering where he actually came from.
Right? I knew you guys would be interested. Mm-hmm.
Yes,
okay.
You know us well.
On to our final screenshot.
Indulge my curiosity. What is the reason that I find you standing here before me once again? Do you hope your foolhardiness will shelter those people? Or was it simply a means of seeking an audience with me? So be it. Well then, you who would defy eternity, time for you to enlighten me.
Wow.
What?
Oh, all right, so it looks like the Traveler gets another chance to confront the Shogun. That's cool.
Yeah.
And I think the situation here is a lot different from the first time they met. But the real question is, what will it take to convince the Shogun to have a change of heart? All of this comes to light in the final battle.
Dun, dun, dun!
Dun, 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 dun.
This is quite the fateful moment, huh? Mm.
Sounds like it.
Let's hope you haven't forgotten your Knights of Favonius training.
Never!
Oh, that would not be good.
No, it would not.
Once again, everyone will need to play through the story themselves to discover what happens.
Okay. I knew you'd say that. I think that's it for version 2.1 storyline. But next, let's take a look at some of the new characters coming our way.
Yes! This is my favorite part. Yay!
Yeah.
I command the thunder in all corners of the world to cease. Rest well tonight.
Dude!
Wow!
That was incredible.
All right.
Yeah.
So, I know that many of you have been waiting to see the Raiden Shogun as a playable character in the game. So, first, let's start things off with a quick preview of the Shogun's abilities.
All right.
Lead us in, Zach. Let's do it.
Okay. The Raiden Shogun possesses an electrognosis and wields a polearm in combat.
Ah, Another Archon that wields a pole arm.
Yes.
Her elemental skill, Transcendence, Baleful Omen, deals electro damage to nearby enemies and will grant each nearby party member an Eye of Stormy Judgment effect.
Okay, that's a pretty intense name, but hopefully it'll be good for the entire team.
That's right.
Okay, so what effects will this grant our characters exactly?
The Eye of Stormy Judgment will perform coordinated attacks alongside the active character, dealing AoE electro damage, as well as increasing the active character's elemental burst damage.
Whoa.
When the Raiden Shogun uses her elemental burst, Secret Art, Musou Shinsetsu, she unleashes the Musou no Hitotachi, causing her to draw her sword and perform attacks with her Tachi for a certain duration. This is called the Musou Ishin State.
Nice. Whoa. So she's switching weapons during her burst.
Yes.
Oh, that is fancy.
Exactly. While using the Musou no Hitotachi, all the Shogun's normal, charged, and plunging attacks will be converted to electro damage that cannot be overridden by any other elemental infusion.
Okay, so it sounds like the Musou no Hitotachi is really as scary as the stories have made it out to be. I am frightened, but we'll be okay. Let's keep going.
When the Shogun's attacks hit an opponent, she will recharge energy for all of her teammates, and she will be immune to electro-charged effects while also having increased resistance to interruption. Finally, the Raiden Shogun's normal, charged, and plunging attack damage will be considered elemental burst damage.
Ooh, that'll come in handy, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
After unlocking the passive talent Enlightened One, if the Shogun's energy recharge surpasses 100%, she'll receive greater energy restoration from Musou Ishin, as well as increase its electro damage bonus.
Wow. Oh, so she can restore energy for her teammates. That's useful.
Oh,
totally
yeah.
Useful. For sure.
I'm really looking forward to her myself. It's so cool how she wields her blade. And all right, let's take a look at our next new playable character.
Yay! Yay!
New friend!
Morning. I've just read a fascinating stratagem. Would you like to study it together?
Whoa! Oh my gosh! Amazing!
Wow!
Here we have Sangonomiya Kokomi. As you can already see, she is a very nimble and graceful character.
She looks really elegant, but also really cool at the same time.
Yeah.
Kind of like a mermaid princess that emerged from the deep in some fairy tale.
That is the perfect.
Oh my gosh, yes!
Yeah. Okay, thank
absolutely.
You.
And Kokomi moves in combat with so much agility, and somehow she manages to maintain that elegant appearance no matter what is going on.
All right, tutorial when?
Yes, I wish I could do that.
So jealous.
All right, so Kokomi has a hydro vision and wields a catalyst in combat. Let's dive in and take a look at her abilities.
Oh, wow, Zach.
That caused me physical pain. But thank you for that.
For that.
I loved it.
Oh, it was amazing.
When she uses her elemental ability called Kurage's Oath, she summons a jellyfish-like illusion called a Bake Kurage. This illusion will remain on the battlefield and continuously restore HP for the active character while attacking nearby enemies, dealing hydro damage.
Kokomi's elemental burst, Nereid's Ascension, deals hydro AoE damage to nearby enemies and causes her to don her ceremonial garment, which increases the damage dealt by her normal and charged attacks, as well as her Bake Kurage.
The ceremonial garment looks so pretty.
It's so floaty.
Yeah. No.
Oh my god, floaty, nice. Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. So pretty. And finally, her passive talent, Princess of Watatsumi, reduces the stamina consumption for teammates when swimming.
She's a princess. She's a princess.
Yeah, I don't know. I the more her. I look at her, the more I think she's a mermaid. Yes.
I'm pretty sure Zach's still gonna drown.
Okay, but you should definitely note that Kokomi has a special trait. Her base crit rate is -100%, which means she doesn't benefit from crit rate or crit damage. However, she does enjoy an increased healing bonus.
Okay. So you lose something, but you also gain something.
Yes, exactly.
Seems like players are going to have a good time jumping in and figuring out the intricacies of this character.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's definitely a lot of cool things going on.
Yeah.
I'm super excited. last but not least, we have one more new character to introduce.
Manifest eternity per the almighty shogun's will. That is what I aspire to.
Whoa. Oh, cool.
Our third new character for version 2.1 will be Kujo Sara.
Hello, Kujo Sara. She's the rival general to Kokomi.
Neat.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, so Kujo Sara is a bow wielder with an electro vision, and her elemental ability, Tengu Storm Call, allows her to backdash and gain crow feather cover.
Don't be shy, Zach. Tell us more.
Will do. When Kujo Sara charges her bow, she consumes crow feather cover. The arrow fired will leave a crow feather behind that will trigger Tengu Jurai Ambush, which deals AoE electro damage and also increases the attack of nearby characters.
Oh, I love that. Yeah, some seriously specialized archer mechanics.
Yeah, I know, right? So after unlocking the talent Decorum, when Tengu Jurai Ambush hits opponents, Kujo Sara will restore energy to all party members based on her current amount of energy recharge.
Oh, cool. I'd like to be her friend.
Yes, right?
I like friends.
Friendship's a good thing.
When Kujo Sara uses her elemental burst, Subjugation, Koko Sendo, she will strike a target area with Tengu Jurai Titanbreaker, dealing AoE electro damage and leaving a number of Tengu Jurai Storm Cluster, which then spread out, dealing more instances of AoE electro damage. These Tengu Jurai will also provide an attack bonus. Nice.
Yeah, Kujo Sara fits really nicely into the support role.
Yeah. Oh, totally, totally. Yeah. And by the way, Kujo Sara's idle animation and elemental burst show her black crow feathers emerging, which definitely wins some style points, I think.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and you know, even with all the characters we have already, these three all really have unique styles and combat abilities.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Yeah. Cool.
Along with the release of these new characters, the new version will also be adding the Imperatrix Umbrosa story quest for the Raiden Shogun, as well as the Dracaena Somnolenta story quest for Sangonamiya Mia Kokomi.
Ooh, more story quests!
Yes. I know!
So great.
These are always such a great opportunity for travelers to get a more in-depth view at new characters and their stories.
Okay, so the big question is, when are all these new characters going to be available to the players?
That's a really good question.
Well, the Raiden Shogun and Kujo Sara will be appearing in the first event wish in version 2.1. Nice. Sangonomiya Kokomi will be appearing in the new version's second event wish.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I love them.
Very nice.
And lastly, we'll be releasing two new 5-star weapons in the version update, Engulfing Lightning, as well as Everlasting Moonglow. We'll be posting more info on those weapons soon, so please be sure to keep an eye out for the official announcements.
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay, so besides those exciting new characters coming our way, version 2.1 still has some huge content for us to reveal.
It's hard to imagine what could be even more exciting than new characters.
Right, well, how about some completely new areas to explore?
Nice! There are more areas to explore already?
Yeah, I know, right? Goodness. Like, I'm still exploring Inazuma.
Seriously.
We already received lots of new areas with the release of Inazuma and version 2.1. We'll be building on that with two more new areas for travelers to explore.
Amazing.
Ooh. Wow. Wow.
The first area is Watatsumi Island, home to the resistance forces. This area is located at a considerable distance from the other islands of Inazuma, so travelers can expect to see peculiar landscapes and unique culture that somewhat differs from that on Narukami Island.
So it sounds like we need a boat.
Yeah. Probably. So a key point of interest on Watatsumi Island is the Sangonomiya Shrine, which lies surrounded by mountains and misty waterfalls. The shrine serves as headquarters for the resistance forces and exudes a dreamy aura.
That's totally dreamy.
I mean, you really weren't kidding about how unique this place is. The scenery here is so different. It almost looks like a completely different world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Agreed.
It's almost like another fantasy world within to that.
That doesn't even seem possible.
So, the people of Watatsumi Island believe in the Great Serpent, which is their god.
Yeah, even the torii gates are different, and the colors of the locals' garb look really unique.
You know, I'm loving the attention to detail here.
Me too.
Oh, it's so good.
All right, now on to the second new area coming in 2.1, Seirai Island. Oh. Hopefully everyone was able to catch a glimpse of Seirai Island from the version 1.6 special program.
Oh, wait, really?
You guys need to pay attention, come on.
Sorry. It's been a while.
Anyway, Seirai Island is constantly enveloped by violent storms. The place has a strange, gloomy atmosphere, so people seldom ever set foot on the island.
Oh, it looks kind of creepy.
Yeah.
The island's ramshackle villages, withering trees, and abandoned shrines all seem to tell the sad history of this area.
I'm honestly trying to figure out why anybody would want to go there.
Fair.
Well, even in a place like this, there are all kinds of interesting things waiting to be explored. For example, we have a talking black cat that is the provisional head priestess of the Asase Shrine.
Say no more, I'm on my way!
We have a reason to go there.
I'm on my way!
So not only does Inazuma have a boss Shiba Inu, it also has a kitty priestess.
Yes. You guys know how I like those cats.
The kitty talks.
We need a foster.
We cannot gloss over the fact that the kitty talks. Look, I'm not gonna lie, this place does look pretty interesting. I'm sure travelers will find plenty to explore there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so totally. Much. And with all these new characters and new areas to explore, what would a new version be without some new enemies to battle?
I was hoping that would be true.
So let's take a look at some of the new monsters that await us in version 2.1.
Yay! Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh. finally a showdown with the Senora herself. You guys, I bet a lot of travelers have been waiting for the chance to challenge her.
Probably.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's right. In fact, Senora will become available as a weekly boss.
Nice. Okay, so even though she's our enemy and I've always wanted to kick her butt, I can't help but notice how cool her fighting style is and also how awesome the music sounds.
That's true.
Yeah, I think she'll be a fun one to add to our list of bosses to challenge every week.
I think so.
Don't you remember what she did to Venti? Now is our chance to avenge him.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. I'm sure he's fine. Anyway. Yeah. This looks like it'll be an amazing experience. Senora not only transforms between cryo and pyro forms during combat, but the environment around her will constantly be shifting as well.
Oof. Man, that's nothing that we can't handle.
Oh, hey, yeah, I know. I'm just saying the players might find themselves in for some surprises.
Yeah, dying to new bosses is my specialty.
Zach, give yourself some credit.
Anyway, I think it's time for us to drop our second redemption code. Code inbound in 3, 2, 1.
It is. Woo-hoo!
Welcome back, everyone! So, we've already covered tons of exciting new features coming in version 2.1, but there are still a couple more things to reveal.
Gosh, it's so hard to believe how much content we're getting. We have been fed! We are being fed, everyone! So full already!
I know! Well, travelers will be seeing a new gameplay mechanic landing in the new version. Guess anyone? It has to do with water!
Let me guess.
Okay.
Scuba diving with Kokomi.
Oh, I like that. That'd be fun. Right? That'd be cool.
Actually, that sounds pretty cool, but no.
Crushing dreams.
In version 2.1, Genshin Impact will be getting an all-new fishing system.
What? Your face!
So fun!
That's right! Travelers will be able to cast their lines for fishing in designated areas of water!
That's so cool.
Oh my goodness, please tell me more about this right now.
Laura, I'm excited.
Okay, the first step to catching any fish is preparing some bait.
Okay.
Depending on the area, travelers will be able to use different kinds of bait to catch different kinds of fish. Exactly. Once you've decided where to fish and have prepared your bait, you can begin fishing.
Oh Yay. My gosh. This is way more detailed than I thought it would be, and I am all about it. I'm so ready.
I know. I know. Okay, so next, you have to cast your line. It's important to choose a place to cast your line that won't scare the fish away.
Oh.
Once you get a bite, you have to time your reaction and control the tension of your line to reel in the fish.
I need to take notes.
Whoa. There sounds like there's actually quite a bit to it, and I can't believe we're actually talking about fishing right now.
I'm so happy.
Yep. And there will be many types of fish to be caught, so travelers can try their best to catch every kind. Fish are not only used to produce a cooking ingredient, but can also be exchanged for rewards. We can even visit the Fishing Association in different areas to exchange for new fishing rods that have different effects to help us catch more fish.
Oh, that sounds so official.
I just love that there's this.
Yes.
I'm gonna die. Okay. I mean, I still think that scuba diving with Kokomi would have been amazing, but like...
Thank you.
Well, hey, listen, I've heard that there are special fish that we can catch called ornamental fish. Is that true?
You are correct. Ornamental fish are a type of particularly energetic fish that travelers can catch and then raise themselves.
Oh. Wait, hold on. What? Are you mean I can raise them like a pet and keep them forever and love them? That's so cool.
Yeah, hang on. We're going to need like a fish bowl or something to keep them in, right?
How about the Serena teapot? We can keep them there.
Yes.
That's a really good idea.
You nailed it, Kelly. In version 2.1, the Serena teapot will be adding a special furnishing called the Pool of Sapphire Grace.
Ooh,
any ornamental fish that players catch can be raised in this special pool.
That's so fun. It is so, crazy how many functions the Serena teapot is getting.
I know.
Like, so many.
Oh, and to celebrate the addition of the fishing system, there will also be a special event in the new version.
Yes. Once travelers think they've got their fishing skills down, they can participate in the Lunar Realm event.
Oh.
They'll receive a special invitation from Inazuma's very own fishing expert, Kujirai Momiji.
Huh?
After some special training, everyone will have the opportunity to seek out the legendary fish, Lunar Leviathan.
Oh. The Lunar Leviathan? I'm not too sure I like the sound of that. It kind of sounds like an ancient sea monster.
Well,
actually, you might be surprised, Kelly. According to fishing legends, and yes, there are fishing legends.
Of course there are.
Don't ask. The Lunar Leviathan, it has the magical power to fulfill someone's wishes.
Okay, yep. Ooh. I'm getting real curious about what this little fishy baby looks like, and if I can love it and keep it forever, please. Can I keep it? Will we be actually able to see the Lunar Leviathan in all of its glory?
I think you know the answer, Laura.
I know. Players will have to play the game to find out.
That's right.
I want to know now.
All right, on to the next event. Mm-hmm. This one should pique your interest. Rumors have it that there's a free-for-all fighting tournament being held in an unknown guild hall near Inazuma City.
Oh.
Whoa. This came out of nowhere.
Oh, yeah.
I know, right?
From fishing to fighting.
Okay, this free-for-all fighting tournament is known as Hyakunin Iki. During this challenge, travelers can either use the trial characters provided or their own characters to form 6 tag teams of 2 characters and give each tag team an event-exclusive ability.
Ooh, so a real test of team combination. I love it.
Exactly, but be careful. If one of your teams goes over the time limit, it will cause your combat abilities to drop.
Oh no.
However, we can use the relay ability to switch to another team to continue combat.
Oh.
Fervor is accumulated by switching teams or defeating enemies. Once you have reached a certain amount of fervor, bonuses will be unlocked for your character's combat abilities.
Oh. Okay, that's interesting. Cool. So it's basically like a relay competition.
Right.
I mean, that sounds pretty sweet. Yeah. What else you got?
Yeah, give us more,
okay,
please.
So, finally, in addition to all the events we've mentioned already, the new version will also feature the Spectral Secrets Expedition event.
Ooh.
In this event, travelers will need to send out expeditions based on information Catherine posts regarding specter sightings.
Oh. Specters are a type of extremely rare elemental creature, no?
That's right. Travelers will need to dispatch expeditions based on recommended elements from the Adventurers Guild for maximum efficiency. Once you have completed a series of expeditions, you will be able to claim the corresponding rewards.
I like rewards.
Sounds like the perfect job for Outrider Amber. Yes.
Okay, so aside from all these amazing events, the Serena Teapot system will also be getting some adjustments too.
Ooh. Nice.
Right.
Yeah.
Starting in version 2.1, when we put multiple of certain furnishings in our realm, the second and any more duplicates will have a reduction to the total load amount.
Oh, okay, great. So this means that travelers can actually put more stuff into their realms than before, right?
Yes, exactly. But it should be noted that the load reduction only applies to furnishings that are placed within the same area.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so if I put a chair in a room and then put another one out in the hall, there's no reduction?
Nope, I'm afraid not.
Okay, gotcha.
Well, we've talked a lot about in-game celebrations and updates so far, but I feel like I remember at the start of the program, we mentioned that we'd also have some exciting events that are not all in-game.
Mm-hmm. That's right!
Great! Like what?
Well,
come on.
We'll be revealing all the details in the next section.
Patience.
And our talented voice artists will also be playing some interactive games together as well. So if you're interested in watching a bunch of Genshin Impact's voice talents tricking each other and sharing some fun facts, stay tuned. For now, let's take another break for our third redemption code.
Yay!
Here we go.
Of today's show, we will be introducing more special events for Genshin Impact's anniversary celebration.
I'm so excited.
Yay!
Yeah, the first anniversary event we would like to share is the Engraved Wishes web event. In this event, travelers can submit their own messages celebrating Genshin Impact's anniversary and have the opportunity for their messages to be engraved onto unique Paimon blocks.
Paimon blocks?
What
are those?
That's a really great question.
I need to know.
These special blocks are engraved with the traveler's comments, will eventually be assembled into a 6'5" Paimon statue.
That is like the biggest Paimon.
Yeah, 6'5" Paimon. That's a big Paimon.
That's so much amazing. That's amazing, though. Like, having our messages engraved on a massive Paimon statue. That will be very commemorative.
Yeah.
I thought about that. The Paimon statue will consist of approximately 50,000 blocks.
That's a lot of blocks.
So,
oh
my God. There will be 50,000 lucky travelers that can have their messages engraved on the Paimon blocks.
Oh, man. I wish I could be one of them.
I know.
Can you imagine?
Me too. More details will be available later via official announcements. Okay. our next anniversary event is related to Genshin Impact's music.
Yeah! Genshin Impact music!
I'm always excited about music, you know that.
For many players, music reflects the first moments and feelings we experienced the very first time we entered the game. So, in order to celebrate the first anniversary of Genshin Impact's release, the game will be hosting an online concert that'll be open to the global audience. Ooh, the show will be featuring musicians from the United States, Belgium, and South Korea playing their own covers of Genshin Impact's amazing music.
That's so cool.
Wow.
That's incredible. And so it's online, so we'll all be able to watch it together, right?
Yes, yes, exactly. Yes. And that's not the only exciting news we have about Genshin Impact's music. The Inazuma-themed OST will also be releasing soon in a collaboration between HoYoMix and Sony Music.
What?
Yeah.
So this soundtrack features live performances by the Tokyo Philharmonic Orchestra from Japan in collaboration with artists of traditional musical instruments. This collaboration was made possible through hours of online communication crossing locations, languages, and cultures.
Wow. Ugh, I have so much respect for all the producers, musicians, and all the staff that's behind all of these soundtracks.
Incredible. I wish I was there when the recording happened.
Your wish is about to come true, Laura. Today, we have some footage of the orchestra's live performance. Let's take a look.
Thank you.
Wow. Amazing. It is so amazing to see the musicians performing.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I'll appreciate the music even more now whenever I'm traveling around Inazuma.
Yeah. Yes.
Right? And there were so many different instruments there. Can you believe it?
Exactly. It's incredible. No, I can't. There's like so many traditional instruments used in the soundtrack. I just
so cool.
Yeah, it was amazing. Okay, so next we have some exclusive info about a savior from another world.
The crossover event. The crossover
event. That's right.
Yeah.
There it is. Many of our viewers might already know that Genshin Impact is going to be having a crossover collaboration with Horizon Zero Dawn. In the crossover event, Aloy, the Nora Huntress, will answer the call of adventure into that and embark on an all-new journey. Let's take a first look at Aloy's gameplay into that.
Yes, let's do it.
Aloy here. I don't know this world, but my arrows are sharp and my bow's ready. If your party needs help, I'll do what I can.
Okay! She knows how to
Dang.
Hunt! She's amazing!
Yeah, totally. Aloy uses a bow as her weapon and wields a cryovision.
Cool.
Her elemental skill, Frozen Wilds, throws a freeze bomb in the targeted direction and triggers an explosion, dealing cryo damage. After the explosion, the freeze bomb scatters into multiple chill water bomblets that explode on contact with opponents or after a short delay, dealing further cryo damage.
Nice.
When a freeze bomb or chill water bomblet hits an opponent, the opponent's attack is decreased.
Oh, wow.
Ooh. That's great.
And at the same time, Aloy will receive a coil stack. This effect increases Aloy's normal attack damage.
Cool.
When she has accumulated 4 coil stacks, Aloy will gain the rushing ice effect, which lasts for a certain duration, during which her normal attack damage will be converted into cryo damage.
Oh. Okay. Mm.
And in addition, after unlocking the passive talent Strong Strike, Aloy constantly increases her cryo damage during rushing ice.
Ooh. Oh, that's so cool.
Right?
So after unlocking the talent Combat Override, the whole party's attack will increase for a certain duration after Aloy gains the coil effect.
Ooh, great.
Yeah.
When unleashing the Elemental Burst Prophecies of Dawn, Aloy throws a power cell filled with cryo in the targeted direction, then detonates it with an arrow, dealing AoE cryo damage.
That's so cool.
Awesome.
Yeah. It seems like this vessel is also a wondrous object that she brought over from her world.
Right? Yeah. For those of you who are curious about how to unlock Aloy, here's what you need to know. All travelers who have reached Adventure Rank 20 or above will be able to obtain this event-exclusive 5-star character directly via in-game mail.
Yep, that's right. So, just to clarify, travelers who log into Genshin Impact on the PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 consoles will receive this character as early as version 2.1, along with the bow, Predator, which Aloy brought from another world. And all other travelers who log into Genshin Impact on other platforms will receive this character in version 2.2.
Great.
Nice.
And another new companion to join us on our journey.
Yeah.
And another bow.
All right. Well, I think that's all we got for this special program. So.
Shova.
Oh.
What?
Zach.
Yeah.
You forgot something, buddy.
Oh, that's right. We still have those interactive mini games to play. I was just testing you guys.
Sure. Oh, were you, Zach? Were you testing us?
Okay. Let's get to the games.
Yay!
Our first mini game is called Guess the Voice. You will have the chance to play along with us.
Yay!
In each round, 4 voice artists will pretend to be the VA behind a certain character and perform one of that character's most famous lines. It's up to our viewers to guess which voice is truly the real voice artist of that character. After all 3 rounds of the game, viewers can submit their answers via a link on our official Facebook post. 3 lucky viewers who send the right answers will receive special gifts from Genshin Impact.
Yay!
Right. Sounds like we are going to have so much fun.
Yes.
All right, travelers out there, remember to note down your choices.
Yes.
Okay, everyone ready? Mm-hmm. Let's start.
Let's go.
Get ready for the gliding champion of Mondstadt.
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 Let the wind lead.
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 Go, Barbara, go!
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 Perfect.
That's amazing.
We're all so good at this.
So, our next game is Never Have I Ever Tabat Edition. Basically, it's a Never Have I Ever game, but with a Genshin twist.
Ooh.
The rules go like this. We'll take turns listing potential experiences we've never had. We'll all start with 3 fingers up, and if anyone in the group has done the action listed, then they put 1 finger down. And if no one in the group has done it, then the person who posed the question puts a finger down. All the experiences we mentioned should be related to Genshin Impact, either something in-game or something related to its recording. All right, everybody, let's get started on game number 2.
All right. Never have I ever picked Lumine. Wait, does everybody else still have their fingers up?
No one else picked Lumine?
Wait,
yes. Not one person here picked Lumine?
I picked Lumine. I'm sorry, okay. I got confused.
Also, I don't know why I did my fingers like that, but...
That wasn't supposed to be as savage as it was, but...
Well, it was, Zach. It was.
Wow.
Okay. Oopsie. Okay.
Sorry, Lumine.
Oh, some truth bombs today.
Oh, it's my turn. Okay. Never have I ever delivered food. Oh.
Oh, like in the game?
In the game.
Oh, well. Don't you all, wait, don't we so all have to? I have done that, so... I
is that a bad that. One? Should you I give it. Another one?
No, oh, got it.
Oh, yeah. Man. Sarah.
Sarah.
Okay. Let's see. Never have I ever pronounced Liyue correctly on the first try. So I'm out.
Never done one. That. What? You're
wait,
just showing up.
Wait.
So, I keep it up if I have pronounced it. Correctly. Oh, okay. No, I mean,
on the first try.
Okay. No, I never have.
That
never.
Was going to be
so confused. I said the rules and I'm still getting it wrong. Okay. Okay, my turn. Never have I ever voiced a character with more than two lines in a cutscene.
Oh, no. So. No, I'm done.
I think I'm...
I'm out. I
no, you're not, so because you've never...
In a cutscene? Oh, wait.
No, you're not. It's the other way. Not. Everyone else has to...
Oh, wait. Oh. No. I did. I played the Moon Carver.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah.
I did.
Bye, Zach. Bye, Zach.
It's been fun. It was short-lived, but fun.
Who's next?
I'm next. Let's see. Never have I ever... killed Timmy's pigeons.
Oh, I haven't done that.
I have killed Timmy's pigeons.
Hi.
Goodbye.
I do play the game, but I refuse to kill his pigeons. Wait, he has in the world. They're all he has.
You're so good-hearted.
You haven't killed his pigeons?
No,
everybody does that.
No, I refuse because they are all that he has in the world, and
you're
can't kill them.
No,
you're just so good-hearted.
Even accidentally? You've never done it?
Nope.
Well, I guess I've never on purpose killed Timmy's pigeons.
Oh, I always do it on purpose.
It's not like I'm a cold-blooded, cold-hearted person. I just wondered what would happen.
You gotta try, huh?
Oh, my goodness.
Okay.
Who's next?
Oh, it's
over
me.
Oh, okay. Okay, Laura.
Never have I ever drowned while swimming. Nobody? You were drowned?
I don't think so.
I think that's something I did to try it out.
I am in the negatives right now. I am in the negatives.
You're slay.
Me too.
Boys are out.
Okay.
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 I think it's my turn. Never have I ever...
Okay, I'm gonna go. Never have I ever picked Ether. All y'all better put your hands.
That sass in there.
All y'all better put your hands.
She'd done her research on that one.
Good job, Sarah.
Thank you. Okay, Laura, it's your turn again.
It's me again? Okay. Mm-hmm. Golly. Never have I ever... never been able to not start the playing the game without saying emergency food. Never have I ever not like imitated Paimon whenever I play the game.
Did you just say one that only yourself is
yeah,
playing?
Yeah, I think you have to put your fingers down. I don't like getting people out.
Okay, you have to put your own finger down.
You have to put your own finger down if you've done it.
I was
know
like...
I have done it. I'm not good at this.
Did that strategy backfire?
Backfire.
I'm not good at this game.
All right, Kelly.
Okay,
okay. It's your turn.
Never have I ever been killed by a boar.
Oh.
Definitely by a boar.
No, not yet.
I feel like I have, but I don't really remember. I'm gonna put my finger down. I can't remember if I.
How did I win, Kelly?
I'm gonna put my finger down.
How did I win?
Baby,
congratulations,
at least you
didn't
put
Kelly!
Yourself out. Completely
unexpected. You didn't put yourself out.
Yay, Kelly!
We are proud of you.
Thank you so much.
The Knights of Favonius are thrilled. Yes.
I love how I'm just like -4 or something.
Oh, that was great.
Wow.
So fun.
That was great.
All right, it's been so much fun kicking off Genshin Impact's anniversary celebrations with these mini games.
Yes.
And now it looks like we're getting to the end of the show. That was so fast.
That was really fast. Yeah.
I love these special programs so much.
Oh, wait. If I remember correctly, this is the first time for Kelly and Josie to join as hosts on a special program, right, guys?
Yeah.
How have you liked it? How has it been?
This has been so fun, like getting to know all the new characters and the new adventures and seeing how the music was performed. Like, my mind is just exploding right now. And, like, thank you so much for having me.
Yay.
Yeah, seriously. So much fun to not only see all of that, but to see it with you guys and to and to get a feel for that and to see it with everybody out there because the players are going to have a lot of fun with this new stuff.
Oh, yeah. Big time. Yeah.
Okay, so for the last part of our show, we have a collection of heartwarming videos from our players. Oh, thank you all so much for an amazing year of memories.
Oh, yeah.
It's been incredible.
We appreciate everyone in the Genshin Impact community so much. Thanks for all your love and support so far, and hope you all enjoy the game and the anniversary celebrations.
Yay!
Yay!
All right, well.
Should we count down?
Let's count down. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Thank you!
And see you in Genshin Impact!
嗨，大家好，我是方块勇士。今天是我成为提瓦特旅行者的305天。
我是神探杰洛特，我已经来到提瓦特大陆将近300天的时间了。
Hello， 大家好，我们是
双双煎蛋。
我们成为提瓦特大陆的旅行者已经多少天来着？
295天左右吧。
对，295。
其实第一次看到原神的 PV《捕风的异乡人》的时候，我就被高质量的画面与音乐所打动，有一种一见钟情的感觉，一下子就能感觉到，对，这就是我喜欢的游戏。
My favorite companion in game is Klee. Some of my favorite moments over the past year have been Klee's story quest, the entirety of the 1.6 update, her voice line, luckily all my new bombs are waterproof, and the excitement of what's to come when we finally meet Klee's mom.
我不是美少女，所以我今天来守护美少年。我是一本正直守护美少年的果子哥。虽说当初因为万叶，
在玩原神的这一年里啊，每天上线去滴不同的角色已经成了一种习惯。虽说这些角色我个个都想滴，但最喜欢的冒险伙伴还是来自御三家的安博和凯亚。安博作为游戏中第一次遇见的角色，就像邻家的女孩子，接地气又可爱。我非常喜欢使用它来瞄准敌人的弱点进行狙击。凯亚则是在深入了解后，发现角色塑造的非常有层次，有种独特的魅力。原神中的每一个角色都很好看，被正直之力呼唤的同时，背后的故事也经得起反复品味。
The most memorable moment in Genshin Impact was when I first had to fight against Dvalin. I had no excellent artifacts or weapons, and I was watching this dragon slapping me left and right. I remember it took me like 30 minutes to clear it, and the cutscene after that just shocked me. I instantly knew that I would fall in love with the game.
印象最深刻的一次活动应该是海灯节，那时候除夕夜嘛，就和朋友一起在里约港放宵灯来跨年。
对，然后因为那时候还处于疫情，然后我们有个朋友独自在外地过年，有一个朋友还在海外留学，所以我们就一起相约在游戏里跨年。
对，然后那天晚上刚好是除夕，里约港又飘起了万家灯火，大家都知道非常好看。
对，然后我们就四个人就俯瞰里约港，
就背后是那种冉冉升起的宵灯，有一种海上生明月，天涯共此时的感觉。
我觉得非常超越现实，就非常非常的难忘。
最开始玩原神，只是因为当时想找个能打发时间的新游戏，没想到一玩就真的停不下来了。除了原神对每一位角色用心的塑造，战斗的体验和操作手感是我在这个游戏当中找到的核心乐趣点。早期开荒的时候，我会研究战斗的机制以及一些副本 BOSS 的特性，并且把它分享出去。慢慢的，我制作的攻略越来越多，关注我的人也越来越多。到现在玩原神也快一年了，真的非常感谢大家的喜欢。
提瓦特大陆就像一个专属的自由小世界，可以在其中做许多想做的事情，比如延时摄影。原神里每一个角色都像被赋予了生命，他们的身世、他们的过往都非常的鲜活，这不免让我好奇，想要更仔细的去观察角色的动作，从慢镜头的角度去探寻他们的一切。原神对于角色设计总能带给我全新的感受，我自己每一次做慢镜头视频的时候都能收获很多的惊喜。
我自己作为一名游戏从业者，其实最大的收获应该是在原神里面找到了很多关于战斗以及大世界探索玩法的一些设计灵感。在大世界探索的过程中呢，我自己还会常常观察各种采集资源的分布区域以及规律，需要该资源的角色对应的一些故事联系，还会分析各种宝箱的分布位置以及谜题设计的一些思路等等。战斗这一块呢，我印象比较深的就是柔头龙王这个 boss 的设计。柔头龙王由于岩元素结晶的反应，它能够额外获得一些其他的元素力进行不同形态的攻击。我觉得这个设定挺有新意的。同时我还会尝试分析各个原神角色的技能机制，他们配对之间产生的一些元素反应，这些都给了我很多自己去做游戏设计上的一些启发。
原神让我从一个只会玩游戏的玩家变成了一个能为原神贡献小小力量，帮助萌新快速成长，帮助社区建设内容的深度玩家。也因为原神，我对自己的日常时间规划也变得更加合理，在上课之外留出时间更新攻略或者摄取其他内容。可以说这段经历帮助我从重度拖延症患者变成了一个更高效的人。
除了游戏内容之外，我也一直被原神的音乐所感动，不论是在蒙德还是在离月，音乐都成了游戏中密不可分的一部分，给了我非常独特的游戏体验。因为觉得原神的音乐非常好听，就开始自己创作一些相关内容，也结识了一群志同道合的小伙伴。
La verdad es que estuve disfrutando durante mucho, mucho tiempo simplemente como un jugador único, yo por mi cuenta jugando al juego. Pero también descubrí que no estaba solo, que había más gente que estaban viviendo esas aventuras en Teyvat por su propia cuenta y que todos además podíamos jugar online. Así que poco a poco fue creciendo la comunidad y fue algo muy bonito, pero no solo personas que conocí gracias a Genshin Impact, sino que muchos amigos que conocía desde mucho tiempo, que por las distancias de vivir tan lejos, había perdido incluso el contacto con algunos de ellos.Ellos también jugaban en sí, tuvimos ese punto de unión una vez más y volvimos a poder jugar juntos y recorrer aventuras como si el tiempo y la distancia no hubiese significado nada, porque Genshin Impact, el mundo de Teyvat, nos unió todos de vuelta.
I have gotten so many friends and family members to download the game and start playing, and every single one of them has fallen in love as well. We all play together, we actually have a group chat.Where we just talk about the plot and the new events, and we make plans to play together and do bosses and domains. I don't think any one of us expected to be so enraptured with the world of Teyvat and all the characters in it and the plot as it's unfolding. It has been a long time, honestly, since I've been so invested in a game and in a world and in a community that I'm so happy to be a part of.
谢谢原神让我不无聊，
原神加油，
冲！
玩原神的每一刻都是很有趣的，要感谢原神给予我这么多快乐的时光。
我一定会永远支持原神，见证原神，我永远喜欢原神。
原神真的带给了我很多的乐趣和惊喜，希望原神能越来越好。同时也希望原神能在剧情上有更多有趣的命题，让玩家们一边成长一边思考。原神加油！